Captain's log, subdate 200405.5. I have replicated a new tricorder and have finished replacing the power coupling. We are now running back on full impulse and should be within visual range of Rilia within the next 2 weeks. Before we start, there's a new video on Moisky Live and I'll be streaming later on Twitch, both linked down below. Today I'd like to talk about two separate instances that cropped up and are somewhat amusing to me. So first we go to Helsden, which is a village in Norfolk, where the police are currently hunting for a truly menacing, terrifying plague doctor. On that note, I noticed the Satiretician, who is a plague doctor, as many will know, see it on the screen here. Yes, I'm going to play his video there, but without the audio. If you want to hear what he has to say, link down below, go subscribe. Hopefully he'll make more videos. He was quite funny until he screwed up, but at least he owned up to it. Good to see you again, mate. So, the Satiretician has been patrolling the village of Helsden. Locals have claimed to be afraid of this unknown domestic terrorist called the Satiretician, as they claim this attention seeker, well, he does upload to YouTube, is creeping and lurking, and worst of all, giving words of advice. Like a level 100 boss Assassin's Creed NPC. Terrifying stuff, I know, and quite frankly, we should 100% support the Helsden police in apprehending and unmasking the Satiretician. Some of the locals have said that the kids would be frightened. My mum would be frightened. I know that even in daylight, if she was to go round the corner and bump into him, she would be so scared. And another resident said, "Scared the life out of my missus. Terrifying for kids." With Jade Gospel, who snapped a photo, this photo, saying, "It's clearly for attention," or something like that, because normal people wouldn't do that. Right, because it is totally out of character for people to dress up and go outside. For example, to put their bins out. Yes, totally out of character. Granted, this guy's not putting, or whammon, is not putting out their rubbish. But still, I have a sneaky feeling that some people don't understand what a plague doctor is. Now, I would have asked the Satiretician to come on my channel and explain himself. Explain to me why he is in Helsden, doxed. Why he is now hassling, harassing, lurking, and giving advice like an NPC. Instead of giving out ointments, potions, herbs, cocaine, tea, and of course to fix all ailments, including the coronavirus. Glitter from a pixie's crack, which, if you didn't know, were all the ingredients that used to be stuffed in a plague doctor's helmet. The beak was supposed to contain the healing stuff, a filter that then helped them so they could treat a patient infected with, let's say, the plague in 1665 without themselves contracting the plague. This is, of course, absolute nonsense. We all know the only reason it exists now is to protect an online women hater who can't help but be a misogynist 24/7. Maybe 25/7 if Lagerstein managed to get that extra hour in the day or not. The police have put out a statement on this, saying that officers have been made aware of an individual has been seen talking around the Helsden area wearing a plague outfit. Although no offences have been committed, officers are keen to trace the individual in order to provide words of advice about the implications of his actions on the local community. With a spokesman adding, "Should any information come forward about any offences being committed, we will act accordingly." I'm sure right now the Satiretician is quivering as he drinks from his boxed wine. Or is it Pepsi? I can't remember. He's a classy bitch. As far as I'm concerned, unless they're actually breaking lockdown rules, because they could just be wearing anything they want to wear and going for their daily exercise, no crime has been committed. Therefore, to those who are afraid of somebody dressed up as a plague doctor, not even knowing what a plague doctor is in the first place, therefore not having a legitimate reason to be afraid, speaks volumes about the level of education in the area of Helsden. Might I recommend somebody just Google plague doctor? Or play Assassin's Creed 2 and, well, better yet, just play Brotherhood. For all you know, it could be the resurrected corpse of Cesare Borgia, doing a little irony. Ah, I wonder if I can still get a plague doctor mask on Etsy. Next, I'd like to go to Florida, because there's always something rather bat shit insane going on in Florida. And oddly, this happens to coincide quite handily with the Satirician, because the Florida man decided to also dress up, but not as a plague doctor. No. No, this one's a classy one. So classy, he got noticed on CNN, who decided to interview him in one of the very first legitimate bits of news they've done in 4 years. No, he went in as a Grim Reaper onto a beach in Florida. Bet that was chill. Or basically, based on how he looked, a B-Tech Dementor. The one thing that separates the B-Tech Dementor from the Satirician is we actually have a name for the Grim Reaper, or B-Tech Dementor. That is Daniel Ulfelder, who is a lawyer and campaigner for Beach Access, who decided to put on the cowl and scythe in an attempt to alert Floridians to the dangers of reopening their economy too soon, something which he stated during the CNN interview, where he said, "We aren't at the point now where we have enough testing, enough data, enough preparation for what's going to be coming to our state from all over the world from this pandemic. I know how beautiful and attractive our beaches are, but if we don't take measures to control things, this virus is going to get really, really out of control." The reason the B-Tech Dementor decided to protest isn't just because of the inadequate numbers so far, but because many states are having issues when it comes to reopening their shuttered economies. Republican governors, for the most part, have already started to move towards swiftly reopening, unlike their Democrat counterparts. Ulfelder's belief is that by protesting, the Democrats will reap donations who are running for Congress. I think there's a guarantee, a very obvious guarantee. You're going to end up with a heat stroke. And I get it, wanting to be proactive to help your party, especially after they lost that state, because we can't rely on those big donors helping Uncle Joe now, can we? Although, do you not see the hypocrisy in you going out to protest against people going onto a beach that you're on? Right, yes. No, that's not hypocrisy at all, is it really? While also telling people, and governors, politicians of all sorts, to not get outside, not to reopen the economy, everyone stay indoors, cause thinking that that will somehow help you monetarily with the congressional elections coming up. Right. Someone hasn't thought this through, lads. Although I will concede, your costume is rather fetching. As a final bit, it is estimated 35,000 cases have been found in Florida, with just over 1,300 deaths. Obviously, I stand by all things I've said before. Anything over one is unacceptable. Until I come by to snap you out of existence twice, and then control what's left, the dust mostly, with my Apple of Eden. Check out my Instagram if you want to see more of that. As with all things we cover here, I'm very much interested to know what you think about these stories, so please do let me know in the comments down below. If I don't see you on Twitch tonight for some fishing Barents Sea, I hope you'll have a fantastic Tuesday, and thank you all for listening. Thank you.
Yes, Zenshinborg.
Ah, I see. You're the ensign of the MSS Krusty.
What do you want?
Well, I have a profitable proposition for you. How about you come and work for me? Well, you'll still work for the octopus, but you'll work for me undercover. How about I give you 50,000 Imperial credits?
Imperial credits? F*** is that?
Wait, what? What's that, Biff? Oh, right, right. Pressed latinum, yes, yes. How does 50 bars of gold-pressed latinum sound, then?
My lobes are tingling.
Cool.